Meet Mosaic, the WordPress theme builder and design system. In this video, we'll walk you through three simple steps of getting started with it. First up, setup. The wizard takes care of the basics so you can start designing in minutes. Next, an overview. We'll explore the editor, the tools, and your canvas. And finally, build. Create your very first page exactly how you imagined it. Getting started is pretty simple. Just install Mosaic, activate the plugin, and boom, you're in. From here, the theme wizard takes the wheel. It sets up a ready-made theme so you can start designing in minutes. I'll go with Monolith this time. Activate your license, grab a coffee. Actually, don't. This only takes a second. Your theme is ready before you even sip. Now the fun part. Dark or light mode. Try a different color skin. Swap fonts, and everything updates instantly in the preview. Next, headers and footers. Mix, match, and swap them straight from the theme's library. Let's see what's up next. This is where you can give your default pages a little makeover, like the homepage. Honestly, I like the default homepage, so I'll leave it as is. No need to overthink it. Let's keep moving. Need more than the basics? You can drop in extra pages right here. Let's throw in a contact page. You'll see a live preview of your pages, and you can rename them whatever you like. Looks good? Hit finish, and Mosaic will build your theme for you. Done and dusted. Welcome to the home for all your templates. On the left, you'll also see your masters, which are parent layouts your pages inherit headers, footers, and navigation from, while each template adds its own unique content. Here's where you'll see all your themes, and you can create a blank one if you're feeling adventurous. All right, let's crack open a homepage template and see what it's made of. Ta-da! The editor. On the top left, first you'll see the Mosaic menu, which is a quick shortcut back to WordPress. Next, the navigator. Here you'll see your page elements laid out in a clear hierarchy. And yep, you can undock it to give your canvas some breathing room. Then there's the add panel, your toolbox of shiny new elements ready to drop right in. On the right side, you'll find your secret weapons. Preview mode lets you check your design, switch views, catch issues, and keep it looking sharp. And here are the breakpoints. Then the settings are where the advanced magic lives. Handle with curiosity. And whenever you're happy, smash that update button, because saving is caring. All right, let's see just how easy it is to create your own page with Mosaic. Step one, create a new WordPress page. We'll make an about page because you probably need one. Hit publish. And now, look at that. The edit in Mosaic button immediately appears. Click it and you'll see three options. Create a brand new template, assign an existing one, or edit the automatically applied one. We're starting fresh because we're brave like that. Apply it, and boom, blank canvas unlocked. Now let's add something from the add panel. I'll grab something from the library. Since it's an about page, let's pick a page layout from the library. The first one looks pretty good, so I'll go with that one. Time to make it ours. Click the heading, tap the edit button, or just double-click it. Press enter or done, and voila, updated instantly. Let's swap out the image the same way and give it a fresh new vibe. Now let's drop in a button. Add it through the navigator or just place it right on the canvas, like this. Now let's make it useful. I'll link it to the contact page we set up earlier. Type a few letters, then select it from the list. Now it links directly to our contact page. Let's change the button text too. Double-click, type, done. And because plain buttons are boring, let's add an icon. Now, I'll drop it in using the navigator. And there it is, right before the text. Now let's swap it. A mail icon would be the perfect fit, and the search bar makes it so easy to find. Great, now let's style this button with classes. See that in the top? It's already using the button element class. Let's stack on a subclass for even more control. From the dropdown, you can see the full class hierarchy. Button is the base, primary builds on it, and L is layered right on top of primary. Now let's round those corners, and for that, we'll use the radius setting. It's already tied to a variable, but feel free to add a new one, or edit the existing ones anytime you like. I'll pick full because it just feels more friendly. Now it's a fully rounded button, and if you change your mind, you can reset with one click. But why stop at one button? Style them all at once, globally. Select the button element class and watch them all update. Let's change the radius again. See, every button is following orders. Okay, set them back to full. Now we've got a squad of perfectly rounded buttons. And yes, you can always reset if you need to bring it back to default. Simple changes, powerful results, and plenty more to explore. So you've got the basics down. Nice work. Now let's look at three powerful features you can try next. First up, components. Think of them as reusable building blocks. It's pretty easy to recognize their instances as they're highlighted in purple, both on the canvas and in the navigator. Now, to make changes to the component itself, just head to the toolbar and click the Edit Component icon. Any changes you make here update across every instance. Watch this. I'll add a button. Align it. Update the text to learn more, and instantly, every instance follows along. But sometimes you only want to change one instance. That's cool too. Just double-click an instance to edit it in its own scope. Here, I'll change this heading to Marketing. See? Only this instance updates. Now, interactions. This is where Mosaic gets fun. They let your elements actually respond to browser events or user actions. Let's add one. I'll pick a continuous scroll interaction. Our target? This instance. Let's fade it in using the opacity property. We'll do it over 60% of the scroll, starting at 0% opacity and ending at 100%. I'll duplicate it for the other instances as well. To adjust the targets, we'll go to the Action tab and quickly select each instance right on the canvas. Takes just a few clicks. Then just drag them around the timeline to stagger their delays. Now check this out. Smooth fade-ins, one after another, all synced to my scroll. So that's a quick peek at components and interactions. All right, one more feature before we wrap up. Let's talk dynamic data. We'll jump back to the templates and open the blog archive template. Here's a loop element that pulls in all your blog posts. Click Edit in the toolbar, and now we're inside its scope. I'll drop in an image element here. And notice, every item in the loop just got an image too. That's because this first item acts as the template. Whatever you add or style here flows through to every item in the list. Now let's make it actually dynamic. Click the dynamic data icon in the toolbar, and boom, a full list of variables pops up. For now, I'll grab the featured image. Click Insert Dynamic Data, and voila, every post in the loop instantly updates with its own image. That's the power of dynamic data. And now we've covered the basics of getting started. All right, let's recap for a second. You installed Mosaic, let the wizard set up your theme, and made it yours in minutes. Then, explored the editor, built your first page, and even tried out components, interactions, and dynamic data. Now, you're up to speed with the basics. Next, push Mosaic further, and make sure you hit that like button. Drop your questions in the comments and join the community. Links in the description. See you next time.